This is Roger Hansen coming back to you with this, with the Praetorian, and this is part three of Who Was Thomas Megley Jr. I've been going through the history of lead and the lead belt mines. This is my next topic. Before I get into the history of freon and gasoline and who Thomas Megley was, that way I can, you know, lay out a pretty good idea of what's going on when it comes to lead and freon and Thomas Megley Jr. So I was going through the health effects of lead, and I'm going to start off there again. Now, the concern about lead's role in cognitive deficits in children has brought about widespread reduction in its use. Lead exposure has been linked to learning disabilities. Most causes of adult elevated blood levels are workplace related. High blood levels are associated with delayed puberty in girls. Lead has been shown many times to permanently reduce the cognitive capacity of children at extremely low levels of exposure. During the 20th century, the use of lead in paint pigments was sharply reduced because of the danger of lead poisoning, especially for children. By the mid-1980s, a significant shift in lead in use patterns had taken place. Much of this shift was the result of the U.S. lead consumers' compliance with environmental regulations that significantly reduced or eliminated the use of lead in non-battery products, including gasoline, paints, solders, and water systems. Lead use is being further curtailed by the European Union's ROHS derivative. Lead may still be found in harmful quantities in stoneware, vinyl, such as that used for tubing and the insulation of electrical cords, and Chinese brass. Older houses may still contain substantial amount of lead paint. White lead paint has been withdrawn from sale in industrialized countries, but the yellow lead chromate is still in use. Old paint should not be stripped by sanding, as this produces inhalable dust. Lead salt used in pottery glazes have on occasionally caused poisoning when acidic drinks such as fruit juice have leached lead ions out of the glaze. It has been suggested that what was known as Devon colic arose from the use of lead-lined presses to extract apple juice in the manufacture of cider. Lead is considered to be particularly harmful for women's ability to reproduce. Lead II or lead II acetate, also known as sugar of lead, was used in the Roman Empire as a sweetener for wine, and some consider this a plausible explanation for the dementia of many Roman emperors, and that chronic lead poisoning contributed to the empire's gradual decline. Okay, so you have biochemistry of poisoning. In the human body, lead exhibits porphobilinogen synthase and ferrochelatase, preventing both porphobilinogen formation and the incorporation of iron into protoporphyrin 4 or IX, the final step in hemisynthesis. This causes ineffective hemisynthesis and subsequent microcytic anemia at lower levels. It acts as a calcium analog, interfering with ion channels during nerve conduction. This is one of the mechanisms by which it interferes with cognition. Acute lead poisoning is treated using disodium calcium adetate and calcium chelate of the disodium salt of ethylene diamine tetracetic acid, which is EDTA. This chelated agent has a greater affinity for lead than for calcium, and so the lead chelate is formed by exchange. This is then excreted in the urine, leaving behind harmless calcium. According to the Agency for Toxic Substance and Disease Registry, a small amount of ingested lead, 1%, will store itself in bones, and the rest will be excreted by an adult through urine and feces within a few weeks of exposure. However, only about 32% of lead will be excreted by a child. Exposure to lead and lead chemicals can occur through inhalation, ingestion, and dermal contact. Most exposure occurs through ingestion or inhalation. In the U.S., the skin exposure is unlikely as leaded gasoline additives are no longer used. Lead exposure is a global issue as lead mining and lead smelting are common in many countries. Most countries have stopped using lead-containing gasoline by 2007. Lead exposure mostly occurs through ingestion. Lead paint is the major source of lead exposure for children. As lead paint deteriorates, it peels, it pulverizes into dust, and then enters the body through hand-to-mouth contact or through contaminated food, water, or alcohol. Ingesting certain home remedy medicines may also expose people to lead or lead compounds. Lead can be ingested through fruits and vegetables contaminated by high levels of lead in the soils they were grown in. Soil is contaminated through particulate accumulation from lead in pipes, lead paint, and residual emissions from leaded gasoline that was used before the Environmental Protection Agency issued the regulation around 1980. The use of lead for water pipes is problematic in areas with soft ore and acidic water. Hard water forms insoluble layers of the pipes, while soft and acidic water dissolves the lead pipes. Inhalation is the second major pathway of exposure, especially for workers in lead-related occupations. Almost all inhaled lead is absorbed into the body. The rate is 20 to 70% for ingested lead. Children absorb more than adults. Dermal exposure may be significant for a narrow category of people working with organic lead compounds, but is of little concern for general population. The rate of skin absorption is also low for inorganic lead. Now that is all I have for the part about lead. And I couldn't believe that almost took up 45 minutes. My next one is going to be on the Lead Belt Mines. Let me see how much more time I have on this part before I get started with it. I have been doing posts on these remedies that I've been hearing about with people like Alex Jones and other people that are endorsing like the use of colloidal alloys and everything, and this kind of fits into what I was talking about there. It's on another channel that I have called The Strange, The Bizarre, The Unusual. I bring that up on that part, just like I brought mercury and lead up on this channel, but I did that for this reason, and there was other reasons involved in that. But it's a good topic to bring up and to discuss, because I think a lot of people don't understand, you know, like, when it, especially with mercury, this type of mentality has been around for ages, okay? People at one time believed that they could take mercury and ingest it into their body and it was good for them, and later on it was found out that it was actually harmful to them. It's just like with lead, you know, the same thing happens there. I mean, during the early part of the 20th century, there were people that were in the merchant marines and people who were in the Navy who suffered really bad, and a lot of them died too because of being contaminated by lead from the paint that was on the boats. You know, being poisoned by this stuff is a very serious thing, and it was just their mentality, you know. A lot of people used it in their drinks, just like it just said, you know. So they didn't see any harm in using lead, just like they didn't see any harm in ingesting mercury. And, you know, that goes back to the Minamata disease. So now I'm going to read about the Lead Belt Mines in southeastern Missouri Lead District. The Southeast Missouri Lead District, commonly called the Lead Belt, is a lead mining district in the southeastern part of Missouri. Countries in the Lead Belt, counties in the Lead Belt include San Francois, Crawford, Dent, Iron, Madison, Reynolds, and Washington. European lead mining started in 1720 by Philip Francois Renault of France, who led a large exploration mission in 1790 and started mining operations in old mines and mine La Motte. The town of Saint Genevieve was founded as a river port for transportation of lead out of the area. Moses Austin started large-scale mining and smelting at Potosi, originally known as Mine of Breton, and founded Herculaneum as his shipping point on the Mississippi. This lead was originally used as a roofing material. Bonnie Terray, T-E-R-R-E, has large subterranean mines now used commercially for recreational scuba diving. The area of mining has changed over the years. The old lead belt is centered around Park Hills and Deslodge. Deslodge. Desloge.